so Paul was just showing the contrast of brothers that was against him, brothers that hated him, brothers that hated his doctrine, and didn't want to follow Paul's teachings and turned the entire congregation of Asia, that region of Asia Minor, against him, as opposed to that brothers that was cool with him and had his back. So you had that same thing going on back then. Same thing. You got brothers that hate you, would make 30 videos against you and turn a whole heap of Israelites against you. Then you got brothers that'll be there for you on your most trying times. They got your back because they love you as a brother. Even in your weaknesses, your shortcomings, and your sins, they still love you and pray for you and wish the best for you as a sincere brother. Whereas other brothers take that opportunity to tear you down because they don't like you anyway. And they take the opportunity to turn people against you.
Right?
So that was going on back then too. So go to 2 Timothy 4 now. Jump right over to the 4th chapter and let's start the 10th verse. So these are just examples of this same stuff that happened in the ancient time. Right? So go ahead.
2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 10.
Go ahead.
For Demas had forsaken me, having loved this present world.
Right, so Paul said Demas, a fellow disciple and laborer, had forsaken him. Because why? He loved the present world. Right? So back then you had disciples and teachers and men that was coming into the ministry and they were still worldly. You got the same thing going on now. Right? Go ahead.
And is departed unto Thessalonica.
Yeah, Cap probably went to party or something. Right, go ahead. Crescens
to
Galatia. Go ahead.
Titus and...
Unto Dalmatia. Right, so different brothers were just, they was departing from Paul for whatever reason. Go ahead.
Only Luke is with me.
Right, so he was still rolling with Luke. Come on.
Take Mark and bring him with thee.
Go ahead.
For he is profitable to me for the ministry.
Go ahead.
And
Tychicus. Go ahead.
Have I sent to
Ephesus. Right. So Paul is showing you the contrast of brothers he was still rolling with and some brothers that departed from him. Some brothers went back into the world. Brothers have contention with him or whatever. Go ahead.
The cloak that I left at Troas with Carpus.
Carpus, yeah. Cloak is a garment. Right. Go ahead. Like a robe or a garment. Go ahead.
When thou comest, bring with thee.
Come on.
And the books.
And the books, go ahead.
But especially the parchment.
Right, the writings that they have. They used to write on parchment. Right, come on.
Alexander.
And notice Paul said he had books, right? Like now we use different books. Right, come on.
Alexander, the coppersmith, did me much evil.
See that? So there was a brother that did Paul much evil. So you had that going on back then. Brothers had issues, they had problems. A lot of times brothers... You don't have to, every time something happened or issue arise with you and a brother, you don't have to get up and bring your business out, air out Israel's dirty laundry all on the internet, man. Right. Have some decency, man. Right. A lot of times what we go through is what we go through. We deal with it amongst ourselves. A brother don't repent, take correction, let the Most High deal with it. Or a lot of times you don't even have to seek. There's plenty of things brothers did to me nobody even know about. I didn't even never bring it up. I spoke to him about it. Repent from that, or Most High gonna deal with you on that. Or I maybe even never got a chance to speak to a brother about it. But I know, he did it. Said, but you know what, Most High, if anything, I'll pray for the brother. Hope he come out of that spirit.
Right.
I let him know years later, I know what you said about me or did that time. You know what I'm saying, brother? That was off. Cat looking at you like you crazy, like, you know about that? You know what I'm saying? So, now that we have the net, put this cat on a blast. Right. Or Israel got to know. Because right. Most of the time, the reason why I say that, most of the time you're not doing it out of sincerity. You're doing it to please other men, or you're doing it to get some pats on your back, or you're doing it for something superficial or sensationalism. You're not doing it because you really love that brother and want to correct him and see that brother get better. Right? Come on.
Of whom be thou where also? For he had greatly withstood our words.
Read.
At my first answer, no man stood with me.
Come on.
But all men forsook me.
Come on.
I pray the Most High that it may not be laid to their charge.
Right, so Paul had a point where he felt like all men forsook him. He only had the Most High with him. And he prayed for them, brother, and said, I hope the Most High led not to their charge. Right? Come on.
Notwithstanding, the Lord stood with me.
Right, so through all this battles and contention, a lot of times Israel, you might feel like you're alone. You might feel like, well, it's so much confusion in the nation, who can I turn to? But you can always turn to the Most High and Yahusha. Uh-huh. Never give up this word, never give up this truth. A whole heap of men might fail you, but the Lord going to stand with you. If he love you and you part of his fold, he going to stand with you. Right? Come on.
And strengthen me.
Come on.
That by me, the preaching might be fully known that all, it's like it, and that all the Gentiles might hear.
Right, because remember, Paul was the apostle mainly to the Gentiles, the Israelite foreigners. Right, and you have remnants of the natural Gentiles that heard and cleaved to the word also. But it was mainly to the Israelites in a Gentile state of mind. Go ahead.
And I will deliver, it's like, and I was delivered out of the mouth of the lion.
Right, because Paul has certain times where he fought. He was a gladiator. He tell you that I fought with beasts at Ephesus. He tell you that in Corinthians. And the Most High delivered him in them battles with a beast or whatever. But the main point being, Paul had contention and he had problems and men did him wrong and evil. And he had to leave off and split from those men and just depend on the Most High. Right. So you had that going on back then. Right, give me 1 Corinthians 1 and 10. In the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 10.
1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 10. Now, I beseech you, brethren.
So Paul said, I beseech you, brethren, or I plead with you, or beg you, brethren. Go ahead.
By Hashem, HaMashiach, Yahushua.
Come on.
That ye all speak the same thing.
See, that's the problem too. A lot of brothers is teaching different things differently. So Paul was saying to the church in Corinth that you all speak the same thing. But the one thing that we can speak the same is HaMashiach Yahusha. We can start from that agreement point there and move forward. Go ahead.
And that there be no divisions among you.
Come on.
But that ye are perfectly joined together in the same mind and in the same judgment.
Right, so that sounds so good. But to bring that into reality is going to take a lot of affliction by the Most High in Israel. Go ahead.
For it had been declared unto me of you, my brethren, by them which are of the house of
Chloe.
Sorry.
Go ahead.
That there are contentions among you.
Go ahead.
Now this I say, every one of you saith, I am of Paul.
I am of what?
I am of Paul.
Go ahead.
I am of Apollos.
Right, so Chloe, Salakia, Chloe, this was a sister that was following the church, and Paul was saying it was declared from her and her household that there was contentions amongst the church back then. Now you have contentions now, right? Come on. And you hell, you got Israel that got contention within congregations. Right. Ain't even from a different congregation, they got contention amongst themselves. They within the same church or congregation, and there's contention in there. Right? Go ahead.
And I of Cephas.
So I'm start 12 again.
1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 12. Now this I say, that every one of you said, I am of Paul.
Right, so you have that back, you had that going on back then. I am of Paul, come on.
And I of Apollos.
I of Apollos, come on.
And I of Cephas.
Come on.
And I of HaMashiach.
Right, see that you had that going on back then. I'm under this man, one comforter, commanding general, the apostle of chief, the high priest of holiness, and all this madness, man. Right, the one and only Savior, Yahweh ben Yahweh. Right, God, Son of God. All this stuff, man. I am this man, I am that man. You got all these different camps and monikers. Like I said earlier, you got so many camps with different letters. I think we covered the whole alphabet. Right, jump WGN. We got next, HOI, IUIC, GOCC, GMS, ISUPK, ICGJC. YPY, I mean, IOG, all these damn things, LOZ, SOW, all these different names and monikers, man, right? But what? It should be of Yahusha. But men, that's another thing, men are claiming camps and men as opposed to Yahusha.
Right.
Now, it's nothing wrong if you say, well, I'm with this particular camp, this is the name of our camp, these are our letters. Because, you know, we want to distinguish ourselves that we are like-minded laborers.
Come.
I'm not mad at you. Fine. have your camp shock out, be the fly guys of Israel or whatever. But then when you start, when you don't distinguish it, you're making it like you're under a man and a camp as opposed to under Yahweh Shai first. And this is the body of men that I labor with. That's what Paul is speaking about here. Right? Stop praising men and making it about a man. And once again, trying to make that preeminence, trying to have that superiority to all. Only Yahweh Shai is superior. Uh-huh. Right? Go ahead.
Is Hamashiach divided?
Is Yahweh Shai divided? Come on.
Was Paul crucified for you?
Paul said, I didn't die for you. Right? So don't say you of me. Right? Come on.
Or were you baptized in the name of Paul?
Right. Were you baptized in the name of Paul? Right? Did Paul baptize you? No. If Paul did baptize you, he baptized you by Hashem Hamashiach Yahweh Shai. Right? Go ahead.
I thank the Most High that I baptized none of you, but
Crispus
and Gaius.
Right, Paul was saying, I'm glad I didn't baptize a lot of y'all cats. Go ahead.
Least any should say that I had baptized in my own name.
Because then cats was going to start giving more credit to Paul than to Mashiach. Right. And that's what's going on now. Is more credit being given to a man than a Mashiach Yahweh Shai?